Hello all. So you have a 3D printer at hand and you're working with a VRoid VTuber model. Wouldn't it be great then to print this model to see your creation come to life? Some recent software updates made it easier than ever, but before we get started, here are some requirements and software downloads for this video. Blender, the VRM plugin for Blender, VRM Posing Desktop from Steam, and VRoid Studio, of course. I will link all the tools into the description below. If you don't have your VTuber model accessible in VRoid Studio, you can try to ask your artist if they can export it in the VRM 1.0 format with transparent meshes deleted. They should know what that means. Other than that, let's go through it step by step. Opening up VRoid Studio, we are heading to the export section. Make sure under reduce polygons, delete transparent meshes has been checked. Click on export and select VRM 1.0. Add a few basic information and then export your model to a location where you can find it again. In the next step, we're generating a pose for our VTuber model. You can pose your model in Blender 2. However, VRM Posing Desktop makes this task way more easier with a new feature which had been added recently. Opening up VRM Posing Desktop, make sure your model is imported into the software. If it is not, you click on change on .vrm at the bottom and then add the VRM you have just exported from VRoid Studio. Now go to select pose at the top and select a pose you would like to have on your model. You can also change some expressions when you go up to blend shape and select the expression you like. In the next step, select the select pose button again and select that little up and down symbol on the left, right next to download it. Here you export your expressions as VRMA animation. Save it somewhere you will find it again. Now open up Blender. You will need the VRM plugin installed. Some instructions on how to do this can be found on the site of the plugin, but basically you have head up to Edit, Preferences, then to Add-ons, and after pressing Install, you select the zip file of that add-on. Sadly, my recording software is not showing this Preferences window. Okay, back to our model. In Blender, first we will delete that cube, so we have a clean working space. Now we will first import the VRM file of our model by selecting File, Import VRM. Our model is imported with a T-pose. To change this, we will import the VRMA file by going to File, Import VRMA. We are done so far. Now select your model, go to File Export, select STL as a file format, and in the options, make sure Include Selection Only is checked. Also under Geometry, Apply Modifiers. Here's a little catch though, VRM models can be horrible. Sometimes you have missing meshes or problems with manifolds. If your slicer software is not able to recalculate and correct these problems, you will need to do that in Blender before exporting your model as an STL. I am using Bamboo Studio as a slicer, so in theory, you could now import that STL into Bamboo Studio, let the software make the corrections and fixes, and then export it as 3MF or STL file again for the slicer of your printer. You can download Bamboo Studio for free and use it without a printer. So that is all. In the end, you should be able to print your VRoid avatar. Only catch all the overhangs. If you're using a FDM printer, you need to work with many supports. Thank you so much for watching and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video so other people can find this information. Take care of yourself and always be awesome to each other. Bye.